Guys, ezibhlungu kayipheli. Shonga mina ningangisukhalele mina. Hey. Na indaba la iyavela. Angazi noma kuyavela ngakho kimi kuyavela ukuthi I ANC they are consistently losing members. People are leaving the ANC. I'm talking about now just general people are like, thank you very much ANC. We are very glad for what you have done for us, but we are not happy with your behavior, and therefore we would like to bid farewell to the ANC. You think I'm telling you lies? Well, there's an article that was released on the 18th of July 2024 at about 11:11 a.m. By a journalist who goes by the name of Khotatso Madisa, working for eTimes Live. Look, the heading of the article says ANC membership drop maybe due to inflated members before national conference, says Umbalula. Now, another hypocrite of note as well is telling us it may be true. This one, don't trust this one. This one, you can trust them all, believe them all, say everything you want to say, but not this one. The same one who goes December 2023 says, January, no load shedding. You guys are not going to see load shedding anymore. January, stage 6. Then he's asked, hey, Bab, you said no load shedding. What is this? He says, why are you asking me? Because, I'm not working at Eskom. Why were you telling us that there's no load shedding when you are not working at Eskom? Why were you speaking for Eskom when you look? You see what I'm trying to say? A man who made a 360 U-turn on a statement he made just a few weeks ago, he then comes around and say, why are they asking me? It is as if people who are asking him that they are attacking him. So we are talking about a person or a pickle off note or a cog off note. So you can't even have to believe him. But again, you don't even have to believe him. Right now, whatever comes out of their mouth is suspicious because they have proven to be liars of note. But the media will not also hold them accountable. Why? Because they are the darling of the media. Now, another problem that we may have seen the ANC losing the membership as well. It is due to Ramaphosa's ill discipline as a politician himself. That guy is not faithful. You know, a man must stand for something. I don't know what Ramaphosa stands for. You know, I know what Zuma stands for. I know what Malema stands for. I know what Zungula stands for. I know where they stand for, but if you were to ask me what IFP stands for, what ANC stands for, I don't even know. What Ramaphosa stands for anymore, I don't even know. But I know also what DA stands for. I know exactly what they stand for, and I'm not confused about what they stand for. I also know what we stand for in this YouTube channel because of this. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying? Will bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed.
So in a way, well, it makes a lot of sense for people to leave because you can't marry a person who is this, and then they made a 360 U-turn from this and they become this, and they still expect you to look and perceive and treat them the same way. I was not married to color red. I was married to color green. At least when you change, invite me to the change. And we sleep. The next day you are a different color. Now I'm supposed to just quickly now adjust to who you are now. No. The article says the ANC is losing member, dropping by almost 200,000 in the past 3 years. People are displeased with the ANC. I told you. It is the style of Ramaphosa's leadership. In December 2021, the ANC had about 865,511 members who are on its system, which dropped to 688,454 by December 2023. This just under 180,000 members lost in 3 years. A significant and worrying dip, according to ANC Secretary General Fikile Mbalula. Okay, that's quite interesting. The party has also seen a drop of 14% in its branches in the same period, from 4,417 in 2021 to 3,425 in 2023. According to the ANC annual report released by Mbalula this week, the drop in the party membership signals a bigger issue of possible bogus membership. That's the problem, because membership fees may possibly paid by for other people for the purpose of the confidence. Okay, there was a need to strengthen membership control, and members were encouraged to manage their own membership on the system, he said. KwaZulu-Natal, Eastern Cape, Gauteng recorded the biggest drop in membership of 42,623 to 40,081 and 20,065 respectively in the past 3 years. The drop is consistent with the dip in party support in May 2029 general and provincial election. The party went from 57% in 2019 to 40% in 2024, right? Forcing it to enter into coalition, right? I pickle elu Ramapo, elu Mbalula ke. Instead of le pickle lelu ukuthi likhulume nje iqiniso ukuthi hey, nathi le leadership yethu nje iyagula nje, idinga pills, idinga umjovo, something of that sort, you know. Ai Mbalula kodwa naye. Kodwa ke uthi Mbalula, this shows that even just on the basis of narrow definition of branches in good standing, there are 14% reduction in number of ANC branches in good standing from a year before, says Mbalula. Most worrying, however, KZN Western Cape, that have 35% of their branches not in good standing since year before, followed by Free State, 14% less. You see, guys, I've got a problem. A problem is there is something that is happening at the ANC with the current leadership. There's a man in the leadership, in the helm of ANC, that doesn't seem to understand the purpose of the ANC. You know, speaking about purpose, maybe I need to say this. There's a statement that was once said by Helen Zille. I think it makes more sense now than it ever made before. Helen Zille once said, when the dust has settled, people will realize that the real battle here is between the TA and the EFF. What does it tell you? It says the ANC is no longer a threat to the opposition, to the enemy. And it just proved that, to say ANC under Ramaphosa is the same as DA. The difference is the colors and the people they're on, but it's the same thing. That is exactly what Helen Zille said. And I don't think you can disagree with her. Do you? Or can you? I don't think so. Tell me. I'm interested to have this constructive conversation. I'm interested to see how you're going to respond to this. But I'm going to tell you this. You know, there's a statement that people once said, to say it worries them, it should worry you if you start to see things the same way your enemy sees things. Now, I once read a book called Great Controversy. Around page 668, it says, when a Christian and a non-believer see things eye to eye, it says, what has changed is the spirit that governs them,
The Christian is now governed by the spirit that governs an unbeliever, meaning they are now governed by a demonic spirit. But this one pretend to be a Christian because they attend a religious gathering, and so they think they are Christian. But if they think the same, definitely sure, their spirit, they are led by the same spirit.